all are in agreement, I will outline my plan to retake Doma Castle. First, Lys and the Doman Irregulars will conduct a series of raids against Imperial targets throughout the surrounding area, with the aim of drawing the garrison's attention. Shortly thereafter, our Zayla allies will launch a surprise attack on the castle's airborne defenses. In this way, we will prevent the enemy's airships from rendering support and cut off one means of escape. Alize and I, together with the Shinobi, will exploit the ensuing chaos to infiltrate the moon gates and disable the Magitek field generators. Once the barrier is down, we will be free to cross the One River and reach Doma Castle. It is at this point that we must turn to our Confederate and Kojin allies. They will commence to bombard the castle with cannon fire while sailing west towards the Doman Enclave.
Wait, the Enclave? Why would you want them to sail away from the castle?
Because the Enclave is home to countless civilians. Once pressed, the Imperials may well think to take them hostage, and I would fain forestall any such attempt. After we have secured the Enclave, we may lay siege to Doma Castle directly. The main strength of the Doman Liberation Front, under Lord Hien's command, shall be committed to this endeavor, as will you and your redoubtable allies. The rest is simple. We scour the castle for the Viceroy, we find her, and we subdue her. Without their leader, what remains of the Imperial's morale will crumble, and they will surrender or attempt to flee. And Doma will be free. Your thoughts, Lord Hien? If any points were unclear or gave you cause for concern, I should be glad to go over them with you.
Nay, 'tis a fine plan. You have a talent for this, that much is plain. We shall carry out Alfano's plan to the letter. Time is of the essence, as you know, so let us each see to our respective preparations. Carry on.
Thank you. Thank you. May I present the Blue Kojin's emissary?
Greetings and well met, old friends. The Elder sends his regards.
Soroban, it's good to have you with us.
If you might humor me. Thank you for coming, Soroban. Doubtless you have already been informed of our plans and the role we would have your people play. However, I seek your counsel as a Kojin of the Blue. Be it by spell or siegecraft, could your forces destroy the underwater foundations of Doma Castle's outer wall?
Explosives coupled with a few incantations. Yes, that might produce sufficient force. Such a thing could indeed be done.
Then I wish to revise the plan. Instead of assisting the Confederacy in securing the Enclave, I would have the Kojin advance upstream beneath the water and breach a segment of the outer wall. I mean to flood Doma Castle.
My lord, the castle is a sacred symbol, the very heart of our nation. To destroy it is unthinkable, unconscionable. You cannot do this.
I can and I will if it improves our chances. By flooding the castle, we remove the better part of their forces from the field and force Yotsuyu to retreat to the highest levels of the keep. Tell me that is not a worthwhile trade.
But my lord, that castle was entrusted to you by your father and his father before him. I say to you again, it is the heart of our nation.
Stone walls do not a nation make, my friend. Her people do. And as long as we yet live, we can rebuild. So let us only think of this battle, of victory here and now. For without that, we have no future.
I see that you are resolved, Lord Hian, and I would not presume to gainsay your decision.
I will inform the Elder of your revised stratagem and instruct our sappers to make ready.
Our preparations are all but complete. Once we receive word from our Kojin allies, we shall set our plans in motion. We shall fight, and we shall prevail.
You're awake. I was just, well, they threw me out, actually. Told me I needed to get some sleep. Ready for the big day. Not long now, eh? I'm nervous, of course, but I also feel like I didn't know where I was going, but maybe finally something's gonna change, you know? Really, really change. And when the dust has settled, we'll see what we've won and what we've lost. I'm going to give it my all tomorrow. Everything I've seen and felt, I won't let it be for nothing. Right, off to bed. Don't want to overdo it, and neither should you. Oh, but before you sleep, you should look in on Alphino and Alize. Quietly, of course.
Another restless soul. Come, come. Raise a glass to freedom.
Good. Good. I should be interested to know her thoughts on the matter.
Now, that's enough, Gosetsu. You'll not convince anyone with your drunken ramblings. We've talked about this, all of us. We are flooding the castle tomorrow, and that's the end of it.
I know, I know. I accepted your decision, and I do not intend to go back on my word. Nevertheless, as the battle draws near, I cannot help but recall our many travails, and it fair compels me to speak. In all my time serving as a leader of men, there are two failures which haunt me to this day. The first, a defeat at the hands of the Empire 25 years past, and the subsequent imprisonment of your father. Long did I consider offering up my life in atonement, until Lord Kyan, allowed at last to receive visitors, called for me, of all people, for my unborn child, he said, for my dearest Shun, live. My second failure, of course, was the betrayal of that selfsame command. When in the rebellion I failed to protect not only Lord Kyan, but Lord Hien too. That I yet live, having known such disgrace, is an affront to the Kami themselves. Yet you, all of you, saw fit to grant this shameful creature, this failure, another chance to serve a greater purpose. Thank you for pitying an old fool.
Now, now, it is far too soon for that. Save your tears for the morrow. You may be sure we will have ample cause to shed them, be they for joy or despair. Even that sounds morose. We who yet walk the path should not think too much on the destination. When the hour arrives, we shall welcome what comes with open arms. is right about one thing, though. We have you and yours to thank for this chance. All debts will be repaid. On that you have my word. But first we must live past tomorrow, no? If you've no intention of sleeping, Yugiri, you may as well join us.
Forgive me, my lord. I did not mean to... if that is your will.
Understood. Wish us luck. Right. You all know what you have to do. Are you ready?
Oh, yes. Ready to show them what a good job they made of breaking us.
Then what are you waiting for? Move out!
Why must we waste our time guarding this blasted...
Sound the alarm! Fluminus is under attack! Armed insurgents have breached the perimeter! We need reinforcements!
This is Lees. Imperial forces converging on our position. Looks like we've got their attention. We'll be sure to keep them busy for as long as we can.
My lady, the riverside wall has been breached. The lower levels are already flooded and the water is still rising.
So I gathered. He would tear the whole thing down, all for the promise of freedom. A noble sacrifice, or the last desperate flailings ever fought. Speaking of which, how fares my brute?
The procedure was carried out as instructed by Lord Aulis. By all indications, it was a success.
Is that so? Then he may yet be of some use. Devotees of vengeance should rightly pursue their cause unto the bitter end, don't you think? Their hearts aflame with passion until the last few embers fizzle and fade, leaving naught but ash. The Viceroy's orders were clear. If Doma falls, none shall be spared his wrath. Tell the men to fight as if their lives depend on it. Because they do.
As you command, my lady.
Again they come to make you kneel, to make you grovel and suffer. But you have endured their worst and survived. You know their tricks. They will not find a flower simply waiting to be plucked.
Have you aught to say for yourself? For what you have done to our people? Your people?
My people, he says. The precious lordling beloved by all come to confront the wicked witch. My parents thought me no better. They woke me from dawn to dusk like an ox or an ass or some other beast of burden. Until, that is, my brother spied a chance to transform the family fortunes. And so I was married to vicious old drunk, who beat me as he pleased. And when I pleaded for help, I was told to grin and bear it. For the family, for him, for everyone's sake. They pretended not to notice, but they knew. They knew! What did it matter? I was nothing to them. Less than nothing. I wasn't of their flesh. I wasn't a fellow Domon. I wasn't even a person. I might just as well have been dead. And then my husband passed away one day. And so I was sold off yet again to pay his debts. But this time, I found a way to live for myself, to survive as a spy for the Empire. Oh, those were the days when the scales first fell from my eyes. No longer would I be a slave to my parents or my husband or the pleasure house. I would be free and receive due compensation. That would be enough, I thought. Until I saw a doorman in the road, beaten and broken. And my heart skipped a beat. Lying at my feet, groaning in agony, sobbing in despair. Powerless, helpless, hopeless. A vision forever seared into my soul. Oh! There was nothing I would not do to feel that joy again. To bend this cruel, twisted world to my whims. Now, having borne witness to my life's work, have you to say to me? T'was kind of you to lend me your ear, my lord. But now it is time for us to conclude our little tete-a-tete with a final game of chance. Who shall stand, and who shall fall? Let the die be cast.
This was her plan from the first, to bring the keep down on our heads!
I will remember your words. We must flee. Order our forces to withdraw.
My lord, while you still can! I cannot hold this forever!
No! We will not leave you behind!
Do your duty! Deliver Lord Hien and the others to safety! Now! Forthwith! I shall manage on my own!
No one leaves. Not you or anyone else.
Tis not this old frame cannot bear. Go now, all of you! The day is won, and the morrow beckons! Nay, thank you! For granting me new purpose and a measure of peace.
Gosetsu. You never failed us. Not once. You served my father faithfully. And I'm a better man for your guidance. And the Doma we build together shall be better for it too. Be proud, my friend. Be proud.
I am, Shun. More than you know.
Hien! Hien!
Gambling was never my vice.
How merciful the gods that I should find you in time. Kasetsu? We must turn back now before it is too late.
Eyes forward, Cyrena. That was his wish.
I will deliver you to safety. The others are waiting.
We brought everyone here. You were the last to arrive.
I see. Thank you. We owe the Confederacy a great debt.
I have waited 25 years for this moment. You owe us naught.
It's Lord Hien!
Lord Hien!
It's him!
He lives! He lives!
Some few words of encouragement would not go amiss, my lord.
Right. Yes, of course. Hearing you say that, I find my courage somehow renewed. Much obliged. We are a sorry lot, are we not? Tired, dirty, stinking of blood and sweat and ash. The people push to the point of breaking. And yet, we won. The perseverance to endure decades of oppression. The will to carry on the legacy of those we have lost. These were the bonds that held us together and gave us the strength to reclaim our home. After 25 hard years, the shadow of the Empire no longer darkens these lands, and we may at last look forward to the dawning of a new day. But, my friends, it will be a day of work. So I ask you, have you yet the strength to stand? To rise up with me once more, here and now, and begin to rebuild our homeland?
This will not end with Doma. We will see to that, right, Lys?
Right.
Indeed, this is but the beginning. The tide is turning, and it shall soon bear us back across the seas and onward and to the next battlefield.
Thank you.
you are. All packed and ready to go?
To the best of my knowledge, yes. Apologies for the wait. The task of tying up loose ends invariably takes longer than one allows. Happily, however, all now seems to be in order.
Then there's nothing left to do but to board the ship. Do try and enjoy the journey, won't you? It may be your last chance to rest for a while.
That would depend on the good captain's choice of route.
As ever, Tataru, I pray you take all due precautions while making your inquiries. Better to avoid the local authorities altogether than risk a repeat of our Ishgardian episode.
And what sordid episode is this, pray tell?
Naught to speak of, I assure you.
You there! Hold that ship!
What are you two doing here? Shouldn't you be in Doma?
Shouldn't you? You left with nary a word. We half wondered if I had done something to offend.
Upon learning that you had departed for Kugane, we immediately resolved to give chase. Our comrades can manage affairs in our absence, and it seemed the least we could do.
You mean you came all this way just to say goodbye?
That too, aye. But there was something else I felt I had to say. You helped us win our freedom, and for that I cannot thank you enough. Accordingly, after we have established an interim government and so forth, I think it only meet that we repay the favor by dispatching our own forces to Eorzea. If you would have us.
We harbored no expectations of such generous aid, and as there is no telling when the Empire might strike back at you, would it not be wiser to concentrate your resources on the defense of Doma?
I had a mind to pursue a more aggressive defense, to wit we will send forth shinobi to provinces far and wide to spread word of our victory, that we might inspire others to take up arms as we did. Even the Empire has its limits. If the Garleans cannot be certain where and when the next rebellion will take place, how can they commit another force to Doma? And besides, so long as this debt remains unpaid, how am I to face myself and Gorsetsa?
As you wish. I will relay your offer to the Eorzean Alliance.
All of Doma is counting on you to finish what we have started. You have it in you, Lys, to seize the future you want. Never forget.
I won't, Yen. Not your words or anything else. Everything that led us here, that will drive us forward, I'll carry it with me always. And that's a promise.
I will hold you to that. Go with them to Eorzea. Tell their people of our triumph and of our pledge to stand with them.
By your leave, I shall pave the way for our new alliance.
Hurry up, you lot! The ship's about to weigh anchor!
It seems our time is at an end. Go well, my friends, and may we meet again beneath a western sky.
Ares knew that woman was unfit for command.
Aye, when you think of all the resources we've poured into that hole, and for what?
Beast yet lives. Mayhap it is time I sharpen my claws. I wonder, will you walk into my parlor once more?
Fadalarem Lupus, come at the command of the Lord Viceroy to present the prisoner taken by the Cranier Lupi. Yea, Galvus, I presume. It's true what they say. You do have the eyes of a monster. A ravenous, insatiable fiend.
You, give the butcher your weapon.
Yes, my lord.
My lord, this is...
A reward given in recognition of your service. I trust it will prove more capable than its former owner.
I swear, I'll not disappoint you, my lord.
Good. Now, silence that mewling little piglet. I would not hear another sound pass her lips until I strip the fat from her.